Yes.
Because I imagine you are with that many outside doing the laws. Ooh, are you okay? Any of you sunburn? Do we have any Brits here tonight? Did you get over excited in the hot heat and like be out in the pool all day? Any of you sunburn? I got very excited on Wednesday. I am very burnt. You just can't see it. I've got a lot of makeup on right now. My back is red raw. Typical Brit abroad. Have any of you been gambling today? Alright, how many of you won something? That's about five people. How many lost? So like, if I ever had the urge to gamble, which thank goodness I don't, because I'd be terrible at it, but probably would love it. But oh, I can't, mate. It's got too much to lose. Fuck me. But I think if I ever gave in to the urge to do it, I'm starting to get the feeling that like blackjack would be my game. But I also, I think if I did it in Vegas, I think if I won, I don't feel like I would have done it the Vegas way. I feel like I have to lose a lot if I'm doing it in Vegas. When I ask the crowd every night, it's always more of lost than win, which means that you can never really win, you know? So you just have to give the money back and all that. But whatever, not here to talk about gambling, are we? We're here to talk about me. So, everybody say hello to Eric, my piano player. Graduation gifts. Lovely. Well, thank you for coming and congratulations. It's absolutely phenomenal. I do like to point out that me and Eric didn't graduate from anywhere. Yeah. Just the school, hard knocks of life. So congratulations. I hope you all go. If some of you are high school graduates, anyone graduate high school? Are you going to go to college? Good. Well, enjoy that. I'm a bit jealous that I didn't get to have the college / we call it university in England. I don't know. Our college is like senior year to us. I don't know. The language is all off sometimes. The American language, not ours. But I didn't get to go to university, and sometimes I really wish that I had. However, if all doesn't go that well, don't worry, because like I said, we didn't go to college or university, and we're fine. So don't worry. Just enjoy yourself and do your heart and do your work with us. Do we have any bachelorette / hen parties here tonight? We have one. We have one in the whole room. Go do it. Good luck, my darling. Congratulations. Have a wonderful wedding. Do we have any divorce parties here? There's always more of those here than there are. The last couple of weekends, we've actually had people who have gotten married earlier in the day. There's one over there. And then they've come to the show. Do we have any weddings here today? Do we have any wedding nights here tonight? Well, congratulations and good luck. I love being married. No way. Is that real? Is that real, sir? You really want my help? Okay, great. Let's put the lights up, please.
See, that's it.
Make me feel my love, Eric.
Thank you.
Congratulations. What amazing timing was that? Also, we really looked very professional, Eric, then, because that looked like it was planned, didn't it? We reacted so quickly. Congratulations, that's absolutely lovely. 2 years and a ring already. Well, that's you fucking lucky, isn't it? Okay, so we have some newly engaged people here as well tonight. Do we have any mothers and their daughters? Do we have any mothers and their sons? That's my favourite categories. Do we have any husbands here tonight? Do we have any husbands here who have kind of been dragged along against their will? That's fine. You haven't got to be too cocky about it, but I don't mind. I don't mind you saying so. But you're going to have fun tonight, and I'm going to turn your wives on, and you're going to end up getting laid tonight. You're going to thank me. That you would do. Do we have anyone here who has not seen this show before? Whose first time is it? So far, this is the end of the weekend for me. But last night and tonight has been a majority of people that really haven't seen it. So do we have any repeat offenders here tonight? Lovely, lovely, our highest compliment. Thank you for coming back. So for those of you who haven't seen this show before, I'm about to pull and drag you headfirst through all of your own emotional dirt and filth. And also mine, so it's a double battle. But I'm going to make you laugh while you do it, because I really do wish I was a comedian, so I test all of you. No slap jokes and all that to you and things like that. And the show is long, so I know I'm chatting a lot right now, but there's a lot of songs to come, and this show is very much a grower and not a shower, so don't worry. And you're a giant egotistical ape. The show very much, it moves around and things like that. There's lots of things that happen. But I'm going to do, there's a lot of piano ballads in this whole show. I'm sure you know that. Hopefully you know who I am and you've come to the show. But I'm going to do two more stripped down piano ballads like this for you in this, like I said, giant egotistical A. Because it makes me feel like I can get to know you a little bit, and that we're just sort of having a bit of a one-on-one, having a cup of tea or something like that. So bear with me while I sing my piano ballads. Do we have anyone who's drunk yet tonight? That's not many, is it, Eric? For a Saturday night in Vegas.
Liar!
Listen, you need to all be drinking more, because the drunker you are, the better I am, okay? I haven't been drinking as much as I used to. That's not many, is it, Eric? For a Saturday night in Vegas. Listen, you need to all be drinking more, because the drunker you are, the better I am, okay? I haven't been drinking as much as I used to.
Love you!
I can hear you, I can't work out what you're saying. Oh, I love you too, I love you too. I haven't been drinking as much as I would like to be. And I can't have one tonight, but I'm going to see how I feel in the morning. Some days I don't really talk, because I have a strong voice stress after my shows and stuff like that. So sometimes it's the perfect time to drink, but also I do like to speak my opinion when I'm drunk. So it's hard to be on voice stress when nobody had a drink, so I'll see how I go this week. I did. Oh my god, I've got to tell you something actually. Oh my god. Obviously, you don't. I know you know me a little bit, but you obviously don't actually know me, so you might not know this about me. But I'm very OCD, which I am. I have been very honest about in the last few years actually, because I am not embarrassed anymore. It's a great part of my personality. And, it's annoying, but I am the most organised person you will ever meet in your life. So, I really set myself up, and I put a lot of pressure on myself in a lot of situations. It could be something big like a show. It could be something as simple as going to my car, right? Okay, it really can escalate, and it's hard to know in what way it will escalate. So when I started back up doing these shows, which was 4 weeks ago, right? And after having a break, there was a few things that I did before the show that I didn't normally do. And then because it was a great first weekend back, I started doing those things I did for the first time. Before every fucking show, right? Because it was a great show. So I associated the great show that the next show will be terrible if I don't do all of these things. And yesterday, before I even hit the stage, I had exhausted myself by pushing myself further than no one even was fucking pushing me to do it. I was just doing it to myself. Anyway, today, so this morning when I woke up, I normally have a very specific routine that I do in the hotel. I was like, you know what, fuck it. I ain't doing it today. So for those of you that don't have an OCD sort of want to be in charge boning your body, that will mean nothing. For those of you that do have OCD and do have those, you'll know how powerful that is, right?
Yeah.
And I sat in the bed, and I was a bit nervous for a minute. It was like I was waiting for like an earthquake or something to happen. I don't know what I was thinking. You think the world's going sometimes. And I know I sound crazy, so I'm also speaking very, very fast. Sorry. Which makes me sound like I might have a meltdown at any moment. Anyway, so I did that. So all of my morning routine was completed. I normally have a bath at like 10:30, and I had it at like 12:50. I leave the room. I leave to come to the venue at like 1:20, right? So me being like, fuck it, I'm going to get in the bath, was mind blowing. And I come out, and I started doing some things. I sign all my things. You'll see when I sign them. I give them to you. And I did them in different orders. I was pushing myself. And then when it came before the show, I decided, I had this song that I like hype myself up to. I was like, I ain't listening to that song today. I'm gonna listen to a different song. That was great. I normally start running around the venue. I'm gonna take a leisurely stroll and I'm gonna do an odd number. Normally I have to do 10, I did 13. Now I know that 13 is a very dodgy number. It's bad luck for some people, but I'm hoping it's gonna be a good show. And in our warm up, because me and Eric get together before we come out and see you guys, I sang very quietly, didn't I? Normally I'm belting my fucking arse and shouting. So I'm excited to see how that pays off for me tonight. Because on Friday morning, all my plans went to shit and everything was delayed and everything went wrong and things like that. And last night was a brilliant show, so it's obviously not that big of a deal. So I'm trying to rewire my brain tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Chicken, I had salmon and it is wreaking fucking havoc inside my stomach. It's hurting and I keep nearly wanting to burp up a whole salmon, I had a salmon fillet, so that's fucking with me a little bit, but the show must go on. Right, I'm gonna do it. So if something goes wrong, hopefully it won't, obviously I'll have a meltdown about it, but just know how it happened, okay, it's because I didn't draw and stuff. I'm gonna do a bit of an oldie for you now. This is a song I wrote when I was a teenager about a lazy Susan table, which will make sense when you hear the lyric in the chorus. This is Turning Tables. Now I know this might be the wrong crowd, but do we have any basketball fans here? Okay, well, I'm a huge basketball fan. Obviously, I'm basically a basketball wife now. But I was always, luckily for him, I was always into basketball. Well, since like 2015. And so obviously we're in the finals. Do we have any Dallas fans? Yeah! Do we have any Boston fans?
Listen,
you ain't got a boo. No one booed you when you were saying you were a Dallas fan. So why don't you listen? This is a completely chill zone in here, okay? No one can hate on each other because of it. So obviously Boston are one up. Do we think that Boston are going to be two up tomorrow?
Yeah!
We have one fan that won't listen to me, one Dallas fan that won't listen to me. I have a feeling that Boston are going to win tomorrow, but then I think it's going to go all the way to game 7. I do, and I'm excited about it. But you know what I was thinking the other day? How nice it is that I would be happy for either side. There are players on both teams, on the Dallas Mavericks and on the Boston Celtics, who I would genuinely be so very happy for if they won the NBA this year. So I'd just like to put that nice energy out there, especially to you, sir, that keeps on doing it. I was having a FaceTime with my friend the other day about... So the Brits in the room will totally understand this. I was FaceTiming my best friend in London. And it's quite hard, you know, I live in LA, and obviously I'm doing shows here, so 8-hour time difference. Oh, I love LA, don't get me wrong, I'm not cussing it at all. It's a pain in the ass because the 8-hour time difference is impossible, right? So it's impossible to stay up to date on to be honest, the shitty day-to-day things that happen in each other's lives, so you miss out on those things, and those are kind of things that are the glue. But anyway, we were on FaceTime absolutely convinced, when I tell you convinced, that England were going to win the Euros this year. Does we have any football, like soccer fans here? So obviously the Euros are coming up, which obviously you're not in because it's the Euros, but still you should watch it because it's fucking brilliant. And after, Jude Bellingham is a fucking wicked player who plays for Real Madrid. I know. And me and my friend have convinced ourselves that because of him that we're going to win the Euros. England were going to win the Euros this year. So does we have any football, like soccer fans here? So obviously the Euros are coming up, which obviously you're not in because it's the Euros, but still you should watch it because it's fucking brilliant. And after, you know, Jude Bellingham is a fucking wicked player, plays for Real Madrid, I know. And me and my friend we convinced ourselves that because of him that we're going to win the Euros. And I'm in Europe during the Euros, right, because I have some massive shows, funnily enough, in Germany the month after the Euros are in Germany. But I'm going to be in England, like, rehearsing and just getting, you know, just getting ready, basically, and being closer to Munich. So it possibly could be my first ever Euros that I go to. And I was like, I'm going to take you to the finals. You know, if I've got to sing the national anthem, I fucking will to get tickets. I won't. I absolutely will not. This is how passionate our FaceTime was. Yeah, that is not a fucking offer. Don't fucking call me. Also, I would definitely accidentally sing God Save the Queen. I'm absolutely. Yeah, I'm doing it. I will sell feet pictures if I need to. But anyway, this is how passionate and fucking convinced we are. We still are. We are still optimistic. But I was like, oh, you know, because I'm going to be in Europe, I'll take you to the finals. This is already us assuming that we're going to be in the fucking finals. Now, listen, I am very patriotic and I will never talk down, but we lost. We lost a game yesterday to a random team I've never heard of. It had nothing to do with the Euros. So my friend was calling me today and I didn't pick up the phone.
Oh.
And I just sent a text being like, oh, no, it's a show day and my voice rest, I can't do it. But at some point I have to take the call and he's just going to make me feel like a fucking clown, isn't he? But anyway, fingers crossed. You know, lots of people don't do well for a long time and then suddenly, bang, they're fucking winners. So I'm still on their side and I will absolutely go into the final even if they're not in it. Okay, that's fine, I'll be doing it because I'm a good sport. I don't boo other teams, you know, I don't. And I love everybody. But anyway, this has turned into a sports pundit show, basically. So thank you and good night. I'm excited to watch the game tomorrow. Okay, so I'm going to do one more piano ballad and then I'm really going to get this show started. Before it, please welcome Loren, Manda and Katie. Come out, girlies! Hello! Sorry, I didn't mean to talk as much again. They're waiting in the wings after hello for me to bring them out during this. And sometimes I talk, like last night, I think I spoke for nearly 35, 40 minutes before this song.
Yes, you did.
Standing there in the wings, being like, anyway. This is taking over. I forgot how he went into the first chorus of that song just then. I then forgot a lyric in my life to that song. There you go. I'm okay. It's okay. I'm still alive. Right, now that you look so beautiful, I can see you all properly. It's time to do my lottery thing. So, Paul, my love, please, can you bring out the trombone? So, for those of you, by the way, you know I said how many piano ballads I have. Obviously, that is very true. But I also have three or four up-tempo little pop bangers. And I'm going to give two more of those to you right after this. So basically, I'm doing all the up-tempos together so that we can, like, pretend that that's what we want, and then we can go back to being usual together after that. Because I don't really believe myself. Oh, I don't want to do anything. Right, so, inside of my trombone, inside my trombone, is every single seat on the very, very top balcony, right? And I'm going to call out one seat number, and you can bring one person down with yourself, and for the rest of the show, down the floor. Samuel, really talking. I can't smell my nose. So, hopefully you just heard what I said. You can bring one person down. So if you're in a group or like a family thing, I mean, I don't really know.
That's your business.
You don't get one person. But if you decide that you don't want to come down one time, my mother stayed up there with her two kids because she was basically here on her own. I know, but I would have left my newborn up there with a stranger or an usher or something. So, but if you can't come down, let me know. I will not be upset. I'll just think that you're crazy and I will call out and I'm not sick. Okay, so we have block 403. That's you guys there, isn't it? Oh, it's row D. D for you know what. I had D last night as well when I was D for danger. And it's seat 307. Row D for danger, seat 307. Put your hands up, both places so I can see you. Is it you? Oh, woo! Take your time, no rush, just go to the nearest usher and I'll send you over. Lovely, lovely. Last night, the first one that I called out, they were going up. And I was like, well, I want to come down there, there's no one in the seat. And so I started calling out another one, and I was like, oh, fuck, hang on a minute. I'm going to try not to swear, because I've spotted about 25 children already in the first 6 months. But you know, I never swear when I'm in an argument or when I'm angry. It's weird. Well, that's a lie. I swear more when I'm just like, oi, why are you sitting down? I'm about to give you two more up-tempos. I'm sorry. I don't want to tell you what to do, but you won't complete your day of steps if you don't at least get a few up on the But anyway, so I'll stop telling you about story because clearly you want to sit down on the couch. Anyway, this is for all of our exes that we really didn't learn anything from because they were that useless. This is telling you to your room.
Just for the time, thank you.
I don't know if it was my choice, if it was like Armageddon. I'm not quite sure what was happening. But I woke up and I was so confused.
What is happening?
So inside of my t-shirt, I'm essentially my great part of the show, which is Debbie's.
What is happening? Oh, what is she doing? A dog? A baby? What is it? Oh, it's a baby!
How old are you?
Oh my god!
I'm 36. Are you enjoying the show so far? Do you like the show? Yeah? Well, I saw it. I was wondering what you were wearing. Now I can see it's your mummy's coat. I thought you were wearing a denim dress. It's very nice to meet you, Kathy. Thank you for coming to my show. Showing you my underwear. Although to be honest, I wear full spats. I actually wear full body spats. See, look, I wear a body. See, I wear a body. And I have to wear cookie socks. I know, it's a real thing happening. Woo! I'm not aiming at the floor, you'll see why. It's very powerful, and when you're in the USA, you will sue me.
I will never!
I'm going to talk about Converse. Because I will teach you how little that I wrote very long. And $50 to go and buy a drink and a bottle of water. So I'll hydrate while you're doing my job. Okay, here we go. Back row. All right. Who got that one? Let me have a look. I lost track. Show us. Okay, great. Middle back. Are you ready? I'm going to do it from here because somehow, no, I don't really understand it, it's physics, it's the shape of the room.
Oh, that is the middle.
Did it make it? Who got it? Did it go to the balcony? Oh, there we go, front row, okay. At least it made it to the balcony. Okie dokie. I've got two more, but I'm going to get some of the stage. Isn't that the first 4 out of 4 I've got this whole little run? Oh my God, guess what? I don't think I told you this yet because I remember and I feel like we have some rooms in the room. And I'm not drunk or anything, so I don't know how I would forget. So this is my 88th show tonight. On the 8th is my 88th show. Woo! Is anyone here in real life, in real life, is anyone's favourite number, number 8?
Oh.
I guess my 55th show did not fall over for me, my lucky number is 5. Okay, well this is a great show for you, and I guess maybe 8 will be one of my, well, we're not halfway through the show yet, I can't, this is acting like my new routine works for me, who knows yet, but let me say hello to my new friends. Hello, oh my dress is going to blow up, hang on. Whose seat did I call out? Yours. What's your, you look lovely, what's your name? Marilyn. And who are you here with tonight, Marilyn? Frank Zappa. Okay, lovely. And are you two married? Are you guys together? Okay. And where have you come from tonight? British Columbia.
Oh!
No one that's ever won a lottery seat has ever said that, so you're all first. And when did you guys get to Vegas? Lovely. What did you do last night and what have you done today? It's personal. Oh, I love that. Questions and I always say, tell me to shut up if you want. So now I am absolutely besotted with you, so I'm going to carry on asking more questions. How long are you guys in Vegas for? 5 days. Are you here for a special occasion? No. Your daughter bought you the tickets to this. What's her name? Elsie. She's not here, is she? Is she in British Columbia? Where is she? She's in where? Alberta. Where is Alberta?
Canada.
Okay, I'm confused. But hi, Kelsey. Hi, darling. If anyone's videoing this, if it's online, thanks for buying my book. And what are you going to do for the rest of the 5 days while you're here? Enjoy it. Do you want to go to any other shows, any restaurants you want to go to? The Sphere. Are you going to go and see the Grateful Dead? Are you going to go to the animal movie? That I get vertigo, so I've been advised very strongly not to go to the Sphere, but that is, does not mean that you shouldn't go. My partner went on opening night when it was U2, and he was like, oh no. Do you know, I've actually met quite a few U2 fans, and they are crazy! They are, and do you know what? I love it, because they've been around from before I was born, and they are still as obsessed with their favourite artists as they always were. I love it. So. I just wasn't sure what was happening there. Okay, so you're going to go to the Sphere. What about any restaurants? Are there any restaurants that you want to go to? Hell's Kitchen. My son loves the beef Wellington there. So I was just like, yeah, very, very nice. Okay, well, enjoy your 5 days and all your personal things that you'll be doing every night. And send my love to Kelsey as well when you get back home, won't you? That's so lovely. And I'm going to dedicate this next song to you guys. And it's more the, before you are, it's more the gesture than the sentiment, because the song is very sad. And you guys make me laugh. And you make me giggle and make, I want so much more Frank Zappa. Right. Sing along with me on this one, okay? Because there's a key change in it. And I'm gonna test you, when you won't know, I'm gonna test you to make sure you're singing along. Or I get to sit down as well for a second. Take us to the chair. Learning to ride a bike, being on the beach, and things like that. I love your suit, you look great. And, which, you know, all have been some of my favourite memories as well. However, when I first started doing these shows, which was, well, by the time I finished it, it would be 2 years, which was wild. 2 years, right? And, well, actually, this was supposed to be, how do you say penultimate? This was supposed to be my penultimate weekend, because next week was supposed to be the end of the residency. But trust me, typical old me, got sick, didn't I? So I had to reschedule some shows, so those are now in October and November. But when I first started this residency, I was like, oh, you know what? I'm going to tell a different memory every single show. Which, for show one, was a great idea. Show 88, not so much. So I definitely have repeated a couple of memories here or there without meaning to, though, not realising. And I am starting to really scrape the barrel with some of my memories, because it's hard to remember all of them.
them, and I try not to like pre-plan them because I don't feel like that's very sincere. I want to try and things that happen to me in the week or on the day, I want things to sort of prompt me what they might be. So sometimes nothing happens to me. Prompts a good one. Before we come on stage, me and the band, we huddle together and we sort of all put our hands in. I guess it's like, remember like Behind the Music, you think you know but you don't. That kind of stuff used to be on MTV or VH, whatever fucking channel it was, I don't know, it was the best. Now we don't have anything like that anymore, which is just depressing, and everyone wants to be on fucking TikTok. But, you know, it looks like you're basically in a prayer circle, but that isn't at all what we're doing. Although maybe some of us are, I'm not. And every show, one of us is the one that leads the sort of oi oi. And today it was one of my backup singers, Katie. And I don't know what made, well, that was it. She said that was exactly what prompted her. So I'm going to start walking around in a minute and singing a song to you, right? And then when I hit the big note, I went up to this boy, he's maybe like 23, maybe even 19, actually. That's very specific, between 18 and 25, sorry. And I gave him the microphone like, to sing with him, and he was one of the worst singers we've had. But an absolute sweetheart. And somehow he managed to get hold of my head and plant a kiss on me, and it was wild, because no one's ever done that to me before. But he was an absolute sweetheart. But obviously my band right now, they can't see us. They can't see any of us, so they're behind the screen, the door's closed, right? Because the fire's magically going to disappear, so the doors are closed. And so they can't see anything to what they can hear. So all they heard was this guy last night singing very out of tune and being very excited. Which prompted her to tell and remind us that when I was last doing my shows, which was not these shows, like, you know, at all, which was many moons ago, it was 2016 and 17. You were there? I loved that show, it was amazing. But so for those of you that were there, rather than like choosing, by the way, the reason I didn't pick anyone to come and say hi to and ask questions was because I spent most of this residency sick and I don't really leave my house, so I've managed to finally put it together, but I think I'm getting sick from the people that I've had in this at my show. So it's not that I don't love you, you just might be sick and not know about it, and I'll be damned if I have had to wear more fucking clothes. Don't be crazy. Anyway, so, but on my last tour I used to invite people up onto my stage. And I would chat away with them and things like that. And she remembered somebody in Lisbon, which was probably, no offence to whatever show you guys came to, but was the best show of that tour, because I'd never been, and I don't know, it's something about the Portuguese, but me, they're so passionate, it's crazy. So it was the loudest, highest energy show that I have ever, to this day, done. The only other place that rivals it is obviously Mexico, of course. Now, I was like, that does sound like me to find a kid that's on crutches to try and climb over a barrier and get on the stage. But she was like, no, he was wearing crutches, but he managed to get up the stage. And I remember there was another time this guy came up, it was in Europe somewhere, and you know, he's very excited and he was sort of like trying to kiss my cheek, and I turned and then we ended up like kissing on the screen like this. It was wild. I'm quite convinced he was probably gay. I was a married woman at the time, it was sensational. It reminded me, and I said, I remember I met this man that brought a dog up on the stage, and then I gave the dog a kiss. I mean, I'm surprised I wasn't getting sick at all those fucking shows as well. But it just reminded me, you know, I've been thinking about it ever since you said it before we came on, and there were so many times. I remember there was this woman at Glastonbury, when I headbanged Glastonbury, and I pulled her up, and she couldn't speak a word of English, and she couldn't understand me, and it was about 220,000 people in front of her, so I totally understand why she shat herself, because I was shit. But then like, she wouldn't say anything, and I couldn't figure out what language to at least try and speak or ask somebody, you know, if anyone would say. But it was fun, and it just gave me fond memories of that tour when I would spot someone there to bring on stage rather than here. I used to spot someone and come talk to them. But anyway, I told you I might be scraping the barrel, but that is my memory. And my 18th show of
Oh, is that me? What is that? A painting? What is it?
spotted a drawing of myself, you know.
Did you do that? How did you do that? I find something else for you in October. I'll have to look on, I'll have to get someone to look on. Tell me what it was, because I don't have social media anymore, so I can't really get back to it. What did I find?
It was
so
sort of
walking through there. Cameron, will you find out what I signed on October the 3rd? Don't worry, I employ people to do stuff like that. Well, this is amazing. Do you want me to keep this, or do you want me to sign it for you? Oh, okay. I haven't seen it yet. I normally, whether I get, for this weekend, I'll get next weekend. But do you want me to sign this for you or something? Do you have a pen? Okay, great. Maybe we should get someone to try and get that from her, because the rules will be different in there because it's so many people. So let's just, everyone remember Teresa.
Yeah.
All right, well, I'll see you for sure. Thank you, that's amazing. You're so kind. So I wanted to say, thank you so much, like I was saying. Thank you for coming with your brilliant energy and love, because it really is infectious. And I've realised the more and more that I've done these shows here, because I've never really been comfortable performing. And I guess maybe like without realising, I'm feeling a bit emotional because obviously this wasn't meant to be the weekend, the last weekend before last weekend, essentially. But I've never really enjoyed being a live performer because my nerves really get the best of me. And did you say fuck my nerves? Be careful saying fuck, because last week some poor fucker got fucking went viral, got abused by the fucker. Be careful saying fuck in front of me. It was funny because I woke up to loads of messages from all my gay friends, be like, girl! And I'd be like, oh yeah, what happened? They were like, you put someone in their place, and then like 3 hours later, they were like, I don't know if he said that, but a lot of my friends were saying he did say it. But basically, just don't shout out fuck randomly to me if I'm talking about something that you shouldn't say fuck about. Anyway, my nerves, I'm learning to conquer them, but it's taken me like 16 years. But before, I think I'd be so in my head, a little bit like what I was touching about at the top of the show about being in a routine and OCD, which I will address that again in a minute because I am thrilled with myself. But sometimes it was so in my head when I was doing shows, I didn't really notice what was going on. And so a lot of the time I'm up here looking, you know, just me looking at you and you looking at me, it feels a bit strange because I'm such a fan of music. And for your hobby and your biggest love to end up becoming your job is obviously fucking amazing, but also quite strange. It is quite strange. And so I'll be so in my head. Be careful shouting out randomly, I'm telling you. I might scold you for nothing. And I wouldn't notice that a lot of the time people had their eyes closed when they were listening to me, watching me on stage, you know, which made me feel less like sort of self-conscious. And I got to realise that in this room because of the size of it. And I also realised just how important the audience that I was always frightened of
is to a show. And I always knew what that was as a fan, because if I was ever at a show and the audience was shit, I'd be fucking livid, you know? I'm like, come on, fucking hell, guys. So I never really interpret that to be the case of my own show. I just wasn't noticing what was going on. And I've really realised, especially on this run that we've been back, that sometimes, you know, an audience is quiet or shy. It's like, that's why I started saying, like, get the fuck up at the beginning, because it's like, your high energy makes us so much better. It really, really does. And it makes us want to give you a different show. And also, if yourselves have a good time. And now, I'm not going to cry about it, because I'm going to unpack it and, like, I'm going to unpack this. But this is the first time that I've ever actually finished something without doing a routine. I might have seen it as well. And this is the first Thank you so much for coming to my show. I know the amount of hard work you have to do to it. Thank you so much. Look after each other on the way out, all right? This is rolling in.